Hello everyone, welcome to lecture on mathematics. Today we are going to discuss polynomials. So let's start. What is polynomial? To learn the polynomial, you must have strong base about algebraic expression, because polynomial is a special type of algebraic expression, or we define the polynomial with the help of algebraic expression. So to learn the polynomial, we first see what is algebraic expression. So let's start with algebraic expression. An algebraic expression is a combination of constant and variable connected by some or all the signs of operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. What is the meaning of this definition? Here it is combination of constant variable. So first we see what is constant and variable, and it contains there is a combination of constant variable, and we are taking it with the help of addition, subtraction and multiplication. Here I have taken the example, that is 4x cube minus 2x square plus 5x plus 3. This expression is nothing but the algebraic expression, because here the 4 into x cube, here it is a symbol into, which is given here. We may take a multiplication or subtraction, addition, and we are taking division. So here we are taken 4 is a constant and x is a variable. So it is a, this expression is a combination of constant and variable, and we have taken the symbols to add here addition, and to subtract we are taken the minus sign. So this is the expression is called algebraic expression. Now what is constant and variable? We see the definition of constant here in the example 4, 2, 5 and 3. If we are taking separate this, then the value of these symbols is fixed. So the value of the symbols is fixed, then that symbol is called constant. So here 4, 2, 5, 3, these are the constant in this expression. And here the value of x is not fixed. You can put the value of x 2, 3, 4 as per your choice. So the value of x is not fixed. The very idea of variable, yes, a symbol which may assign by different number or values is called variable. Here we are taking different values of x. Now next is, if we are taking the first term, second term, what is the term here? 4x cube, 2x square, 5x and 3. Here we have taken the first 4x cube, second 2x square, third 5x and fourth is 3. Actually these are nothing but the terms of our expression. So if first term in our expression is 4x cube, similarly second term in our expression is 2x square, and so on. So these are the terms in our expression. Now let's start with what is polynomial. An algebraic expression of the form a0 plus a1x plus a2x square and so on an x raised to e power n, where a0, a1, a2 and so on an are real numbers and n is a non-negative integer is called polynomial in x. It is denoted by p of x. Any general notation to represent the polynomial. It means here p of x equals to this equation is called polynomial. And a0 to an, these are the constant real number. That means here the value is fixed and it is a real numbers. We know real numbers. If you don't know real number, then see the previous lecture. Now next we see the example of polynomial. Here I have taken the 6 example. If you observe the example number 1, then coefficient of x are real numbers. That is 2, minus 5, 1, these are the real numbers, and power of x is positive. So example 1 is polynomial. Similarly example number 2, here the coefficient of x is 2 by 3, that is a rational number, and rational number is again contained in real number. So it is again real number, and here power of x is positive. It means This example number second is again a polynomial. Now, in example number 3, here power of x is positive and coefficient are real number, because under root of 6 is again a real number, that is a irrational number, and irrational number, rational number is subsets of real number. So this third example is again a polynomial, and fourth one contains two variable, but still it is a contain power positive and coefficients are real. So example number 1, 2, 3, 4 are polynomial. In example number 5, here the second term contain 1 by x. If we take 1 by x in numerator, then we get power of x is minus 1. So here the negative integer contain in the power, and we know that if the power contain negative number, then that is not a polynomial. So example number 5 is not a polynomial. Similarly, in example number 6, here power is minus 2, and again power is negative, so it is not a example of polynomial. So we can say here example number 1 to 4, these are polynomial, but example number 6, 5 and 6 are not polynomial. Now we see here example number 1 and 2 and 3, 1, 2, 3, these are contain only single variable x. So this polynomial is called single one variable polynomial, because it contain only one variable. But in example number 4, it contains two variables, that is x and y. So the example number 4 is called polynomial in two variable. Or we can say example number 4 is a polynomial of more than one variable, because it contains more than one variable. Now next we see constant polynomial. Here I have taken the example 5. Is it a polynomial? Yes, it is polynomial, because 5, you can write 5 is nothing but 5 into x raised to a power 0, because any number raised to a power 0 is 1. So this 5 you can represent in the form of x, and it is a polynomial. And this similarly 5, you can take 4, 8, 1000 or any number, these are also polynomial. It means any constant is a polynomial, and that constant is called constant polynomial. Now next we see zero polynomial. Here zero is again a polynomial. Zero, why zero is a polynomial? Because zero you can also express in the form of x. See here, zero into x, again we get 0, so 0 is a polynomial. Also you can write 0 into x raised to the power n, or you can write 0 x raised to the power 3 plus 0 x raised to the power 2, and so on. It means 0 is a polynomial, and you can express in the form of x, but in any form, you as per your choice, you can express 0 in the form of x. Now next we see what is degree of polynomial. It's an important concept. Find the degree of polynomial. Most of the time in exam ask degree of polynomial. So let's start with the definition. The highest power of variable, here we have to take highest power of variable. We know variable is x, y, z, these are the variables. Highest power of variable in the polynomial is called degree of polynomial. For example, here example 1, 2, 3 and 4, these are the polynomials which we have already discussed, these are the polynomials in one variable. If we observe the example 1, here in example number 1, highest power of x is 3. So we can say the degree of example number 1, the degree of polynomial is 3. Similarly, if you observe example number 2, then degree of this polynomial is Yes, highest power of x is 4. So the degree of example number 6, example number 2 is 4. And in example number 3, highest power of x is 3. So the degree of polynomial is 3. Now, if we are taking the constant polynomial, then what is the degree of that constant polynomial? Here, suppose we take 5, then tell me the degree of this polynomial. Yes, you can write 5 is nothing but 5 x raised to the power 0, because x raised to the power 0 is 1, and here multiply 5 into 1 is 5. So the 5 you can represent in the form of x, that is 5 into x raised to the power 0. Here highest power of x is 0, therefore we can say 0 is a degree of constant polynomial. Instead of 5, you can take any number, any constant number, then that constant is a polynomial and degree of constant polynomial is 0. Now, if we are taking the 0 polynomial, then the degree of polynomial is here. If we are taking 0, then 0 you can represent in any form of the x. That is, 0 is nothing but 0 x raised to the power n. Then degree of polynomial is not defined, because 0 you can express in any form of x. Any power of x you can take 0 into. So 0 is represent, 0 polynomial is represent in a different form. That's why the degree of 0 polynomial is not defined. Now next we see, if the polynomial in more than one variable, it means in example number 4 we have seen that contain x and y, two variable, and here if the polynomial contain one and more than one variable, then what then the degree is then we have to find degree. To find the degree of polynomial, we have to take summation of the powers of variable. That is, take the summation of the power of the variable in each term. The highest sum is called degree of polynomial. This definition we see with the help of example. Here, the example 4x cube y plus 2x square y raised to the power 5 plus 8y raised to the power 6. If we take summation of the powers of term, here we have to consider one by one term. Here first term is 4x cube y. If we take sum of the power, then we get here 4. In the second term, sum of the power x square y raised to the power 5. So 5 plus 2 is 7, the summation is 7. In second term, it contains single variable, so power, highest power is 6. Now compare this 4, 7, 6 and take maximum value, that is 7 is the maximum. So we can say 7 is the degree of given polynomial. In the next lecture, we see, that is, how to add, subtract and division of polynomial. Thank you.
Thank you. Like, share and subscribe.